Hello, marhaba, shlonkum ahwalkum, what's up everybody, and welcome back with another video here with Rami the Iraqi. Today, I want to go ahead and give you some Iraqi words that if you literally translate it to English, it doesn't make sense. They're kind of like Iraqi word expressions or idioms that we use in the Iraqi dialect. So let's go ahead and dive into it. The first word that we have is tah. Hadlak, tah hadlak. If I want to literally translate tah hadlak, tah means like someone fell or something fell. Hadlak, had means your luck. So that means your luck fell if you literally translate it. Now let's try to use it in a scenario. For example, your mom tells you to go grab a cup of water, okay? And then you're holding the cup of water, but then you spilled it on top of her, let's say, Louis Vuitton purse that shouldn't really get wet, okay? And then she's gonna say, "Tahadlak, intibih ya ibni." So she's like, "Tahadlak, like, are you serious? Like, pay attention." So you could use it in these kind of scenario when something, like someone does a bad thing that they shouldn't have done. All right, so the next word that we have is Mudak, mudak. So this one could also be related to tahadlak. That's why I put it right next to tahadlak. Because let's say you drop the water on the purse. She could say tahadlak, mudak. Mudak. It's kind of like you use it with your hand gesture, like mudak, like mudak. Like you shouldn't do that. Why are you doing this? Mudak. I don't really know how to translate it, but you also use mudak in the same context as when you use tahavak. All right, so next up we have klauchi. So klauchi, let's say it's someone that's going to trick you. So for example, you go to a store to buy something and the guy's like, look, this new watch that I got, I bought it for 100 dinar, and look, I'm not even making any money on it. I promise you, I'm gonna sell it for you for 100 dinar. This is how much I wanna like help you. So this guy is klauchi, because you could grab that watch, buy it, and then go somewhere else and you see that they're selling the watch for 80 dinar, for example. Okay, so that's a klauchi, someone that's going to go ahead and trick you. And since we're talking about klauchi, luti is kind of in the same context as klauchi. Luti is also someone that's like shady or someone that is sneaky. So let me think of an example. So luti could be like someone is going to convince you to do something that you shouldn't do, or something that is fake. I always think of these people that sell you the 4 weeks for transformation, or lose 30 pounds in 4 weeks, or try this belt and you're gonna lose all the fat, try this pill, or all these people, they're lutiye. That's the plural of luti. Because you can't have the dream body in 4 weeks. You gotta work for it for like 4-10 years, okay? You can't lose 30 pounds in like 2 weeks or in 1 week, okay? That's unhealthy. And that person is luti, okay? So don't believe that person. Klauchi and luti. All right, so the next one is sarat zahma. Sarat zahma is like, it's becoming busy, it's becoming crowded, okay? So sarat zahma, you use it, you have two ways of using it. A good way and kind of like judging someone way. Let's say you go over to someone's house and they give you food, give you everything. They tell you, go ahead, take a seat. We'll make this and that for you. And then give you like 10 different type of dishes of food. And then you're like, sarat zahma. Like, I hope like I'm not troubling you. Like you don't have to do this, sarat zahma. Versus the other way of using it, by judging someone, it's exactly the opposite of how I just used it. So you tell someone to grab you a cup of water, and instead of filling the cup of water to the rim, they bring it to you half full, and then they give it to you. And then you look at them, you look at the water, you look at them. Sarat zahma. El glass nassa farag. the cup is half full. Like, صار الزحمة, like, what's going on? So that's the two kind of ways that you can use it. In a good way, if someone like really hospitable and bring you all the food or bring you something or they bring you something that's done halfway, you use صار الزحمة. And the next one is نعيماً. نعيماً. So نعيم, the word نعيم, نعيماً is blissful or paradise. That's what it means. But we use it in two ways. When someone just get a clean haircut. So let me know in the comments if I deserve a نعيماً, because I got a fresh haircut and I trimmed my beard. So if someone trim his beard, you can say نعيماً. Fresh haircut, you can say نعيماً. And someone just stepped out of the shower, and I just stepped out of the shower too. So let me know if I deserve a نعيماً or not in the comment section. So this is the two ways, or three ways, I guess. Shave your beard, get like cleaned up, get a haircut, get out of the shower. And the last one, finally, why did I keep it here? Because it kind of means finally, The video is going to end soon. So is, like I said, finally. Give you an example. You could use it, let's say you take your little kid to get a haircut. Kids don't like haircuts, and sometimes they cry, like, and then the barber is gonna say, خلصنا. And he could literally say it the whole time he's giving him a haircut. And I've heard it so many times, that's it, خلصنا, خلصنا means we're done. Or you could use it literally with everything. I just finished my homework. خلصت وهسه راح اروح العب Call of Duty. Like, I finished and now I'm gonna go play Call of Duty. So this is the first part of the Iraqi words, expressions, idioms. I'm gonna go ahead and make another part in the near future for you. And I hope you enjoyed today's video. And as usual, thank you for the support. Share it with your friends and family. Subscribe, like the video if you liked it, and I will see you in the next episode.